Now, I like these fragrances because they are so powerful, long-lasting, and you will smell different than any other fragrance out there.
And between you and me, they're a little bit sexual as well.
Let's go to my top 5 Middle Eastern perfumes. Number 5, Abdul Samad Al Qureshi Heritage Blend. Oh my god, guys. This one is easy to wear. It's woody, a little bit more on the masculine side, but a girl can pull it off if you're not that feminine. It stays close to the skin, but it lasts for a long time. You can easily wear this on summer days as well, because it's not a strong, skanky oud. I just wish it projected a little bit more, but I got a helping hand with that. And that is my Ambroxan. If a fragrance doesn't project so good and doesn't give that push, I'll make it push. With these two together, you smell sexy. Number 4 is Makan Blend. All right, so this one is also from Abdul Samad Al Qureshi, and this one is a little bit different. It smells like deer musk with a little bit soapiness and a little bit of a powdery note. Also a little bit of vanilla, but this is not a sweet fragrance at all. It is a really weird combination, but you will smell really good with this one, and this one as well gives me a lot of compliments. But again, it doesn't project so good. So I use the Ambroxan to make it project more. And if I wear these two, it gives me so many compliments. Arabian Oud Kalimat Black. Alright. So, do you see how much I have worn this fragrance? Oh. This is a little bit smoky. Vanilla, this is a sweet fragrance. It has amber, and this is really Middle Eastern. And I make it more Middle Eastern because layer it with real oud oil. And I top it off with, again, Ambroxan. I think I need to do a whole other video about Ambroxan. When I wear these three together, even the people who don't give me a compliment want to know what it is, what they smell. And they tell me that it smells good. So this one is already really different on itself. I make it project more and I put a little bit of skank to it. It's not really skanky, but for normal people, an oud oil is really skanky. I will show you one day how I wear this. This combination will give you a lot of compliments because all the people will smell you. And you know, Curly is in the house, so everybody needs to smell me. Number 2 is this one together. But I will first talk about this one. This one is Safari Extreme, again from Abdul Samad Al Qureshi. I love that house. Alright, so this one smells like, it is a suede leather. The suede leather is like at the top. This is a leather fragrance with vanilla. Really different than anything out there. And to me, this smells like a man with money. Your girl can't just smell like a man with money. She needs a little bit of help of her. This is the Safari Oil of Abdul Samad Al Qureshi. Together, layered, it makes it more feminine. Then you're just a classy woman who rules her business. This, you smell ylang ylang, vanilla, and you smell ylang ylang, vanilla, and some woods. And together, one time, a client of mine said like, are you wearing an Arabian fragrance? And I was like, yeah, I do. And she said like, yeah, I can still smell you, because it was my last client. I had her at 10 in the evening and I already started working at 1. So you can see how good this one lasts. But it's not really projecting so far. This one together gives you nice whiffs, but it will last like 16 hours. Well, that's good for Curly. Yes, girl. This is It is Gold by Yas Perfumes. Many compliments by guys. When they smelled it on me, they all asked like, what is that fragrance? Is that a Tom Ford? And I was like, no. It's an Arabian fragrance, because if I tell what it is, they wouldn't know. And they're like, yeah, I can smell that it is in a different perfume. Is there oud in it? And I was like, oh, yeah. There's oud in it. All right, so a lot of guys compliment me with this and they think it's a different one than anything else, but they think it's good. This one smells like Bocour, when you enter the this a lot in Dubai when you enter the malls. Bocour here, Bocour there.
Bocour here, Bocour there.
And oh my god, that's just such an amazing smell. But it's not just only that. It smells like a smoky oud with shisha. You know, shisha from shisha bar? So a fruity shisha with the smoke of oud. This is very good, and as you can see how much I've worn this, it's good. Get it. So these were my top 5 Middle Eastern perfumes, and they are not so hard to wear. You just need to wear them a couple of times, but they will give you a lot of compliments for men and women. Trust me, guys. All right, what kind of Arabian perfumes do you wear? Do I need to check out? Like, leave a comment. These were my top 5 Middle Eastern perfumes. I hope you like my list. I enjoyed making it. Let me know what you thought about this list. Leave a comment, leave a like, and then I will make some next videos. Bye bye, guys.